Another day, another Watch Mojo. Although this time, this is going to be the most savage Simon Cowell insults. Probably around last year, I've decided to check out some American Idol worst auctions and whatnot. It's what really sells it with American Idol, X Factors, pretty much any talent shows, is the guy, Simon Cowell. I love Judge Judy because half the time she insults idiots and whatnot. And this right here is Simon Cowell throwing insults to bad singers and people with bad talents. And boy, is it a dream. The first time I've heard of Simon Cowell, and it wasn't until I put together last year, was that Simon Cowell appeared in Far, Far Away Idol and Shrek 2. So, a long time ago, I've seen Simon Cowell, and I sort of liked the guy, although I didn't know any better back then. But nowadays, I just like him even more now. And I've seen some talents where... I've seen a video where he stops an auction, and it's like, hey, wait a minute, something's missing, basically. And then when they try, when the auctions try again the second time, he's like, yeah. I mean, this guy likes to is savage and likes to throw insults and whatnot and has no problem being rude and whatnot. But he also, but the thing is, he tells the truth. He tells it as it is, and that's what I like him for. I mean, if he told me I was a bad singer, I wouldn't blame him. This guy tells the truth as it is, and in some cases, he could see talent coming from a mile away. And there are other times where he just gives the auctioneers, the contestants, a little push. Top 10 most savage Simon Cowell insults. Here we go. Oh boy. I might miss some Simon Cowell insults, but who cares? Hopefully I might see some here.
Does this man have any filter? Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 Simon Cowell insults.
But I just think you should give us a chance.
But a chance to do what?
To improve.
Yeah, girls, we have weeks, not decades.
Before we begin, we publish new videos every day, so be sure to subscribe for more great content. For this list, we're looking at the meanest, funniest, and most creative insults ever thrown at contestants by Judge Simon Cowell. Whatever the show, if Simon Cowell's destroying dreams, it is eligible for this list. Number 10, only person in it, the X Factor. It's one thing to be told that you can't win against steep competition. It's another thing entirely when you're informed that you still couldn't claim the title even if all other participants were taken out of the equation. But if Simon says it, it's probably true. Only telling the contestant he can't win was only the beginning. Simon adds hyperbole to insult, stating it wouldn't happen even in a million years.
You couldn't win this competition if you were the only person in it.
Though perhaps not his most original line, you have to appreciate the savage honesty of it. The heartbreak on the contestant's face says it all. Simon has successfully crushed yet another dream.
In a million years.
Number 9. Nightmare. American Idol. Some people dream of shadowy figures dragging them off into another dimension. Others dream of falling, spiders, or things that go bump in the night. Simon's nightmares, however, feature dreadful singing, a fact that he's felt compelled to share with more than one contestant during the audition process.
Vanessa, if anyone ever asks me in my life what my nightmares look and sound like, I'm going to refer to that.
To be fair, though, he does listen to a lot of terrible vocals, so it's only natural they'd seep into his subconscious. In this case, the contestant's voice literally sounds like the shriek of a banshee. Simon had stopped her sooner. Number 8, the most disillusioned group, the X Factor.
I think you're probably the most disillusioned group of people we've had in this competition. And that's the truth.
Oh boy, this is a long insult if ever we've heard one. Every time Simon pauses while delivering this soul crusher of a line, you can see the group silently praying that's the end of it. But sure enough, he's always got one more cutting point to make.
I think individually you're weak. I think as a group you're even worse.
By the time he's actually finished, Simon has criticized their originality, talent, and edge, both as a group and as individuals. He then essentially tells them to never perform again. Ouch. What Ouch. Must really hurt is the fact that he knows what he's talking about when it comes to groups. He did give us One Direction after all.
I'm in love with you.
I'm sorry, he did? I never really looked at the song, but did he star in a song or make a song? I mean, okay, this is Simon Cowell. He knows what he's talking about. He's one of the greatest judges ever. Not court judges, but...
Number 7. Horrible. Horrible. American Idol. Simon's not one to employ a gentle vocabulary when giving constructive criticism. Horrible is an extreme word to use in any situation, and the fact that he repeats it over and over again, referencing different parts of the act, is just ruthless.
It was a horrible, horrible song choice.
Yeah.
It was a horrible, horrible presentation.
Thankfully, Simon does find one redeeming quality in the performance. The fact that they stopped it early.
There was absolutely nothing redeeming in it other than the fact that we stopped it early.
It's definitely a verbal beatdown. And the contestant's response is pretty much the only thing he could say. Because, let's face it, there is no arguing with Simon. Number 6. Completely and utterly
Oh, I see this one!
Britain's Got Talent. Here we have a young dancer by the name of David who aspires to be like Justin Timberlake. Unfortunately, he just isn't up to scratch. And that's putting it lightly in comparison to what Simon has to say about him.
David, look, the truth is, you are completely and utterly useless.
We're not sure useless was the right word to use, but it's safe to say that everyone is in agreement about stopping the act. David curses at the audience and runs off like a child. He has a chance to apologize, but unfortunately, his sensitive side rears its ugly head once more. And the situation only worsens.
Nobody is...
Useless is a pretty strong word, and at some cases it could be incorrect or a bit too much. But if you were talking about being a useless dancer, that seems pretty accurate.
Number 5, One of Those Creatures, American Idol.
I can't take it anymore.
Yeah, nor can I.
We know Simon doesn't hold back when critiquing singing voices and is known to show tough love. But making fun of one's appearance is a little uncalled for. While the contestant doesn't have the best dancing moves or vocals, according to Simon, his appearance isn't great either.
You look a little odd, your dancing is terrible, the singing was horrendous, and you look like one of those creatures that live in the jungle with those massive eyes.
Simon compares him to a creature in the jungle, quote, with those massive eyes. Whether they agree with the bush baby comparison or not, the other judges, despite their best efforts, cannot help but laugh. Thankfully, the contestant has a good attitude and doesn't lash out like we've seen other contestants do.
Simon, you're going to say what you're going to say, but you know what?
Yep.
That's your opinion. You're entitled to
it. But it's a pretty good opinion.
Number 4, Mr. Boring, American Idol. Boy, Ian Bernardo sure is an interesting character.
I'm totally going to be the next American Idol, and you will be definitely calling me on the phone saying, Ian, can we hang out? And I'll be saying no, and I'll be hanging up.
But interesting doesn't mean talented. And without so much as a half-decent performance to back it up, his flamboyant persona did him no favors with Simon. Bernardo's rendition of Gloria might have been painful, but his reaction to Cowell's criticism was downright excruciating.
And it's not funny, you're not good at anything.
Having already made it clear to Ian that he has no talent, Simon takes aim and delivers the kill shot, calling Ian Mr. Boring after the contestant questions
Mr.
the Brit's
Boring.
Legal status in the country. Unwilling to let it go, Ian is soon escorted out by security. If only that had been the last we'd see of him.
Take Mr. Boring out.
Mr. Boring out? Who are you?
Number 3, I'm glad you did. American Idol.
Mr. Boy, I love that. Take Mr. Boring out of it.
It's easy to tell when someone's off key or has botched a note. And it should be easy enough to determine when someone's finished singing. But not with this contestant. She stops in the most awkward of places. And it understandably catches the judges off guard.
A moment like this.
The way Simon quickly stops her from continuing, however, is hilarious, proving that sometimes the subtlest of insults can be the most cutting.
Oh, okay, it's a weird place to stop.
Oh.
No, I'm glad you did.
You can tell by the look on his face that he has not enjoyed it one bit.
No, I'm glad you did.
He desperately wishes to avoid having her continue. Considering how often he stops contestants from singing mid-performance, it was nice for one to finally do it for him. Number 2, worst singer in the world, American Idol.
You've got to hear yourself to believe it. There is nobody on this planet who sings like you.
It's one thing being called the worst singer in America, but in the world...
I've seen this. Just what was going through that guy's head when he decides to act all sexy and whatnot? Seriously, what was going through his head? And he called Simon Cowell the biggest jerk in the world. You're an idiot!
World? That's gotta be tough to hear. The judges can't hide their laughter, but they nonetheless give him a chance to sing a second song. Unbeknownst to Keith, it's at his expense, so the judges can continue watching in amusement. Simon then cuts straight to the chase, smashing the young man's hopes and dreams.
Last year, I described someone as being the worst singer in America. I think you're possibly the worst singer in the world.
You'd think Keith would have called it quits after that, but proving that he still had more to offer, he subjected himself to Simon's scrutiny once again a decade later on The X Factor, where he won over the audience and judges alike.
I'm sorry, what?
Had more to offer, he subjected himself to Simon's scrutiny once again a decade later on The X Factor, where he won over the audience and judges alike. Number 1.
So, wait a minute, wait. This guy... Did this guy make a comeback and is far better than he already is to the point where the judges says yes? I mean, I don't really watch contestants that come back. Usually.
Get a lawyer. Get a lawyer. American Idol.
I know.
You taking singing lessons?
Yes, I do.
Who's your teacher?
There was this lady up in Montana.
While Simon's insults are entertaining, it's often the look on the contestants' face afterwards that makes them. Simon has a habit of asking a series of questions or telling an anecdote that could go either way before he gets to the punchline. And this right here is his magnum opus.
Do you have a lawyer?
No, I don't have a lawyer.
Get a lawyer and sue her.
Delivering 2 insults for the price of 1, he instructs the next contestant to sue her singing teacher. Ouch. Something tells us that this particular case didn't make it to trial, but the moment went down in the history books as one seriously well-delivered insult.
Do you...
Damn. Get a lawyer. It's actually kind of amusing. It reminds me of that one blonde fat girl who sang horribly. There was the number 7 worst American Idol auctions ever part 2 video, and number 7 was that fat woman singing. It's like she was like, why, in high pitched voice, and it was awful. And she claims that she has a degree in vocal performance. And I saw a few YouTube commenters that pretty much said she got the blonde woman contestant got scammed. In fact, I am curious now. Has there been any cases whatsoever where the contestant ends up suing their singing teacher? Has there been any cases like that? Like, after they go on a talent show, the judges are like, you are a horrible singer. Who's your teacher? You need to get a lawyer against that teacher. And then the contestants are like, I'm a horrible singer. You told me I was good. And they decide to make a case. And did they win or lose? Has there ever been any cases? If any of you guys know this or decide to check it out, please let me know in the comments below. I just love to see that. Though it does make me wonder if Judge Judy would think that it's a case or not. Or it's not a case. Like how a roommate is suing someone because they aren't good roommates. If you like what you see, please consider liking and subscribing to my channel. It helps out a lot. And I hope you have a good day or night, and take care.